Welcome to Rutana's Boxing Stop, and today we have my first entry in the series I have planned, so I will take a look at how good it's received from all of you. Weekly pickups. I guess after the flea market video that I'll just try it out, how it goes, and all the pickups I show you today arrived between Wednesday last week and yesterday. So we'll see how this format goes, and the very beginning of this video will make two spoilers for future videos. The first one is in this big package, and I don't wrap it up much because I know what it is, and you will find out next Tuesday on this channel. Little hint, this is the Shaq Fu Switch Collector's Edition. Yay! So, if you want to see what's inside, tune in Tuesday. The second little spoiler is for my second channel, Rutana Unboxing. Next Wednesday, we'll have a lewd anime, and it's quirky. Alright, so much to the spoilers. Now let's see what I've got, what arrived here, what I picked up. And yeah, let's go through it. The first thing that arrived is the Force of Nintendo Fans. It's a Nintendo magazine that's supported over Patreon. You can purchase the issues on Patreon. As you can see, it's Nintendo Labo themed, and it has a little robot papercraft toy that you can build up as well. This magazine is also available as PDF file if you don't want a physical copy, but I find it neat to have a physical Nintendo magazine in hand after all these years. And yeah, I'm looking forward to dig into the articles in this. It's the first issue that I've got, so I have no idea yet what to expect, but I'm looking forward to it. Right. Next thing I picked up, or that arrived, keep in mind, I order a lot of pre-orders, so I never know when they arrive, and sometimes it's a lot at one time, and sometimes I only get a few things. So let's right go on to the next pickups. Which are vinyls. Now, the Yeti has these nice boxes, but wraps them up in plastic again. I removed the plastic already, and these ended up at the customs. And then we have another vinyl that I got from Minimum Records. Let's check out the Yeti stuff first. So, first vinyls that we have here. As you may know from my Twitter, I'm collecting video game vinyls. So here we have Symphony of the Night. It's Shovel Knight remixes. Has a digital code here as well. And yeah, let's take a look into it. Now the vinyl itself has this neat grey marble effect. This looks awesome. And there's a plastic sheet over with a title. sitzen hier. Well stored. Overall, I really love how they made this vinyl. Here's the back. Let's get this back into the sleeve again. I already always like to keep them when they are reusable, because the more protection the better. Next up we have the Celeste soundtrack. Now this is sealed shut, so I will not... Oh, why not? I will open it up. I usually don't open the records up until I'm actually listening to them. But why the heck not? Take a look at the vinyls itself. I love how colorful they've become. I've got enough black vinyls in my childhood to not need another black vinyl again. Very nice art inside. And we have a little description about the game and the music. It's a double vinyl, and it's this wonderful teal blue. It's really teal. It comes across as blue on the camera as far as I see, but it's teal. One thing I don't like, most companies make their slipcases so extremely narrow that it's hard to get the vinyl back in, unless you're absolutely straight. Right, that is actually a method that works. The first one is a nice ice blue with a small marble effect, as you can see. It's a bit stronger on the back. So I guess we have the icy mountain on this vinyl and the teal sky on the other one. I haven't played the game yet, I want to eventually, but since I have a huge backlog, I wait with these titles until there's a physical version available, because I bet that Celeste is in work at either Limited Run Games or Super Rare Games. One of them will make a physical version of it, I'm sure of it. So. Looking forward to listen to the music, so. The second package, I ordered them, this was one order by the way, but they split it up in two packages to secure shipment. Make sure it all arrives safely. And these were all record store day pickups. So here we have a slip mat. I couldn't pass on it. It was super cheap and hey, it's earthbound. And it surely looks cool on the actual turntable. So we have Flint Hook. Another game I haven't played yet. Let's open it up. Okay, a little bit of the slipcase, the plastic slipcase, has broken off, as it seems, but I guess that's what the slipcase is there for, to protect the actual vinyl. So I won't complain. Here we have Lindhook. Ah, again, the title is on the plastic slipcase, and you have the hook effect from the game. This is pretty neat. Oh, here's the actual back with the tracks. And the vinyl itself is right nice and pink. Don't know why pink. I don't know how this connects to the game itself, but I love it. Whee! Back is just the hook. Oh, it's got a bit more damage up here, which makes me wonder if I should tell the idiot. They usually were very, very clint with customer friendly with replacing vinyls that got damaged during shipping. Next up, we have Tumbleseed, as you can see. Let's open it up. Right. The blue coat. I hope it wasn't visible. yeah, it's a code paper for CMP3s. Okay, even if it's visible, I'll make sure I'll download it before I upload the video. Not a biggie. Okay, here we have it. It's a wonderful picture vinyl of Tumbleseed. This is a gorgeous vinyl. Really loving the design. Oh, that's what's in the vinyl. Okay. Again, I love how colorful vinyls have become over the time. And again, I love it when the slip cases are nice and big, so you don't have the issue with getting the vinyls back in. Also, I love this effect of the matte black. This is really nice. Alright. Then we have the last vinyl package here from Minimum Records. Again, I picked this up during record store day, I guess. And it's Lightfield. I have no idea about the game or the music of the game. Absolutely no idea. But so far I've never gone wrong with video game vinyls. I often buy them rather blindly, often for games I haven't played or heard of. But I have yet to be disappointed. the inside. I guess it's some kind of robot game. Space game. Let's see. The blue ones here. This is a slipcase. Oil itself was pure white. As you can see. There's a red symbol on it. It is also pure white. Alright. Okay, I'm looking forward to actually listen to the music. And this wraps up the vinyls. So we come to the next topic of this video, which is small artist supportment, basically. First thing we have here comes from Luz on Twitter. I'll put her Twitter handle and her shop link in the description. Because again, this is also to support small artists. I ordered from her before and she's super nice. Her products are really, really good. Let's see what is this. That's a bill. And invoice. Nobody wants to see that. And this time it's more original stuff from her. She has that world that she builds up where three groups are researching. These characters are not belonging to it, but these were nice and cute charms, so I picked them up even without knowing the characters. Again, original characters from her. And these are the three badges from these three groups. It's the Seafarers of Ankaram, who research the oceans and water life. Then we have the Herbalists of Serandril, who, well, are herbalists and research insects as well, like butterflies and such. And here we have the Stargazers of Celestida, which is the group I would sort myself into, who are astrologists, basically. And fitting to the orders, to the badges, here we have the wax-sealed envelopes of all three. Now, I will not open them up in front of the camera. I want to encourage you to buy the stuff. So, this is something I will not show. But inside are the guidebooks and the introduction, basically, to each group. So, yeah, if this sounds a little bit interesting for you, it's a world where magic is able to be performed and technology by music. So, if this sounds anything interesting to you, check out her shop and get these things yourself. They're not expensive. And I will not break the seals, by the way. I will open it up here. It's too much of a shame to open up the seals. Now the last things. Here we've got a little personal note of her, Which I always find nice when artists include a little note. Here we have two prints, three prints, sorry. This, I don't know exactly where it's coming from. I guess it's another of the original series, but I really liked the imagery. So I picked it up as well. And here we have the ocean life. That's the seafarers of Ankarop. Ankaram. Research. And here we have the Lepidore, the butterflies that the herbalists of Central Serandril research. I love these beautiful designs. I hope she makes a third print for the Stargazers of Celestida as well, because that would be really, really awesome. But my personal highlight of all of this, I must say, is this little art sign. It's a Return to Happiness. It's Holy Majora's Mask. And I won't show everything. I will only show a few excerpts. What I really loved about this is that each drawing is for one of the side characters, one of the NPCs. The only link you will see is on the cover. Everything else are drawings of the side characters of Majora's Mask, which I find really, really awesome. As these are characters that are less likely depicted in art, but they are what makes Majora's Mask so special. So I can highly recommend this art sign. It's wonderful, the art is wonderful, the topics is wonderful. Really pick, go to her shop, pick up her stuff. It's worthwhile. I'll promise you, it's absolutely worth the money. Let me quickly wrap this up. Next up, we've got this envelope, and yes, this was controlled by the customs, and I had to pay customs for it, but that's not an issue. And it's a wonderful set of charms and stickers from Vio. And as you can already see, it's all Doki Doki Literature Club. Here we have Monica. We have Natsuki. Sayuri. And we have Yuri. If you follow me on Twitter, you know that I love Doki Doki Literature Club so much. It's my favorite game of 2017, and I can only recommend you playing it. But heed the warnings before, don't take them lightly. It's a business card, violin box. But again, I'll put her Twitter handle and her shop on the description of the video, and I will show you the front sides of the charms first, because the back sides are spoilery. Yes, my favorite girl, Sayuri. I want breakfast. See. Literature Club President Monica, don't forget to save your game. Dafang Best Natsuki. Manga is literature. She's absolutely right, it is. And we have the Silent Yuri. I'm kind of into knives. Yeah, she has a knife collection. So, Before I show the back, here's a spoiler warning. If you don't want to be spoiled of Doki Doki Literature Club and you shouldn't really, really go in blind, then skip forward to the timestamp I show in the video, just to be safe. Alright, so I'll show you the spoilers. Sayuri's backside. He's glitched up. Get out of my head. Natsuki's backside. Fucking Monica. What's that, Monica's backside? Which is pretty much unleasable. I'm now anywhere, I guess. And we have Yuri's backside. I want you all to myself. I really love the backsides as they are wonderfully fitting to the game and theme, and I find the idea very, very cool. And yeah, I love the fitting heart charms underneath, and the blue keyring is actually something special. She had a few of these on a convention, and I asked her on Twitter if she could reserve some for me because I really love this blue keychain. So yeah, I got the special ones. So yeah, that's the mark I picked up from her. Again, can only recommend her, and these are really, really cool. She has other stuff besides of Doki Doki Literature Club as well, so go check her out. Oh, and the stickers were a surprise. Apparently she puts these stickers in with every charm purchase, as far as I can tell from Twitter, so keep that in mind as well. Next up, we have a letter here. I just don't show the front because of the addresses. And these are mini prints from Chivka. I'm sorry, I don't always have the names in mind so much. I have a terrible memory when it comes to names. This is not to be taken personally, please. Again, the sticker was a surprise, which I really, really love. Lucina is so cool and sweet. Here's her card. Again, you can find all the information for her, her Twitter handle and her shop link in the description as well. Again, a little thank you note, which I like. And from her, I ordered these two mini prints. She draws Fire Emblem girls with glasses, and I'm absolutely in love with the designs and with the imagery. I find glasses are something beautiful, and seeing them on Fire Emblem characters is really, really sweet. So again, the shipment was super fast, prices were absolutely fair, so go to her shop, go pick out some stuff if you like it. She has a lot more than just these mini prints, so yeah, check her out. And the last thing we've got for today, which just arrived today as well. Again, I won't show the back because of the addresses. It's from May or Mango or Irochigai. I'll put the Twitter handle and links on the description. And from her, I got 2 charms and 2 washi tapes. I love washi tapes and kind of collect them. I won't show the full design, I'm sorry, but go check her shop out if you like the things you see so far, because I want to put it on my diary again and put the rest of it on letters or such. Yeah, this is a Pokemon washi tape. And the second one is a Kingdom Hearts washi tape. It's a Sleeping Organization 13, which I found really, really cute. The charms. Charms are both Fire Emblem and they still have the protective foil over it, so let me remove them quickly. Alright, foil's removed. So, these charms were made to celebrate the arrival of both male and female Morgan and Fire Emblem heroes. So, here Robin hugs his 2 kids. There's this nice star keychain. And here we have him nicely together with his 2 kids, and as a bonus, the Grima versions on the back. Now this is that what this side is what actually put me to buying these charms, because I love how creepy they look. I love everything creepy, and this is just amazing and awesome, and I love it so much. I had to pick it up and picked up the rest on the go, on the fly. Really loving these charms. I'm so hyped about these. So yeah, go check her shop out. You'll surely find something you like. And yeah, this marks the end of the pickup video. I hope you enjoyed this little new format. If not, let me know. If you did, let me also know. And I hope I see you again. Thank you so much for watching. See ya! Thank you so much for watching. You can check out my other videos covering collector's editions on the playlist on the upper left. Expect a new video on this channel every Tuesday and Thursday, and a LEGO Dimension video every Friday. Take a look on my other channel covering mystery box unboxings on the lower right. Until next time, see ya!